So I'm going to talk about the eRapid technology, which is about decentralizing diagnostics. Why do we want to do that? Is because there has been increasing number of diagnostic testing worldwide, and that demands for better clinical care models, which needs to be cost effective. And the way the trend is going on with all the artificial intelligence, cloud system, telemedicine, everything is going towards the patient, leading to patient empowerment. Let me give you an example of such a device, a glucometer, used by millions of people around the world to monitor their glucose levels. The eRapid technology is approaching this by looking into electrochemical sensors. The way it works is whenever there's a molecular binding event happening at the electrode surface, it induces an electrical change that is picked up by the system and converted into a user-friendly output. It has many advantages over optical systems, like being miniaturized, low cost, you can do multiplexing, and it can be easily integrated into a handheld version. Now you must be wondering, why not just use a glucometer-like device? We cannot use that because the glucometer-like devices are based on enzymes. And using enzymes, you're just limited to a certain level or certain number of ligands. In order to achieve a wide variety of targets, we have to look into affinity-based sensing. But in case of affinity-based electrochemical sensing, there has not been any commercial success. One of the biggest challenges to tackle is biofouling. What I mean by biofouling is when you use these sensors with complex matrices like blood, plasma, or serum, you have binding of off targets that can either lead to false positive signals, or you can have total passivation of the electrode surface because of insulation effect. I'm going to introduce you to three critical innovations of eRapid technology by which I would like to convince that we can truly address all these challenges and deliver a handheld version. Starting with how we are combating biofouling. Many research groups have tried to address this challenge by looking into surface chemistry, which could be broadly divided into self-assembled monolayer and polymer chemistry. But these comes with disadvantages. If you see the graph and you see the currents of the bare gold, and if you actually coat any metal surface, you're essentially making a metal insulating. You always lose some kind of conductivity. With these traditional methods, you lose more than 50% of the conductivity of the sensors. And if you challenge these sensors with complex matrices, you lose most of the sensitivity within 1 hour. We are approaching this by developing a 3D porous material, which is comprising of BSA, which are cross-linked together by incorporating nanomaterials like gold nanowires, carbon nanotubes, or reduced graphene, for instance. What essentially we created is a semi-permeable membrane. And when we challenge these sensors with complex matrices like human plasma or human serum, over a month, we retain more than 80% of the conductivity. Now you can use these sensors to link the antibodies and do a traditional ELISA. It's a simple drop casting system with manufacturing capabilities leading to commercialization at the same time. Now we have a sensor, we wanted to see if we can actually detect a target. Anaphylaxis is a life-threatening allergic reaction. We have to look into a marker that is instantly released in your body during an allergic reaction in order to produce or develop a rapid diagnostic test. And that is where we got acquainted with histamine, the smallest molecule that you can actually detect in your body through affinity-based sensing. And if you actually look how small the histamine is, it also makes it the most challenging one. And the histamine levels are quite correlated with the symptoms a patient feels or experiences during an allergic reaction. And the biggest clinical unmet need is that there's no diagnostic assay out there. So like any other research group, we started with a commercial histamine assay strategy. And as you can see in the graph, we couldn't reach the clinical need, which was below 10 nanomolar. We developed our own assay strategy, which not only increased the initial intensity 5-fold, but also brought the limit of detection within the clinical range. And then we translated this on our electrochemical eRapid platform and developed a rapid diagnostic test for histamine with just 10 microliters of human plasma. Now this was all about detecting single molecule. What about if there's a need of multiplexing? What if we want to detect multiple targets on the same chip? Like if you want to know the whole profile of your heart, for instance. The way we are approaching multiplexing is through precipitating TMB. And the way it works is you have the local precipitation of the substrate at the reaction site where the molecular binding event happens. This way you don't see any cross-reactivity between the neighboring electrodes. And if you flush these electrodes now, you can still retain all the signal. That means you don't have to do the measurement right away. Another unmet need, which is sepsis. we developed a multiplex panel for sepsis where we individually modified each electrode with a particular marker of interest. And if you see the results, you can see that just with 10 microliters of whole blood in less than 60 minutes, you can either detect one, two, or all of them together. That was a really good proof of concept for looking into multiplex platform on the same chip without doing any kind of sophisticated engineering there. We actually looked in the whole range of analytes that we could detect on the platform, ranging from as small as histamine, which is 100 Dalton, to as big as antibodies, which is 150 kilodalton. And with this institute project, we would like to develop a multiplex sensor for clinically relevant analytes for at least one of the life-threatening conditions that requires rapid detection, heart attack or anaphylaxis.